Imagine you do a clean install of Windows using the official Windows 10 or 11 ISO file from Microsoft, and once you get to the desktop, it looks like this. There's no Microsoft Edge or OneDrive, no pre-installed bloatware apps like the widgets or Copilot for example, and the start menu is clean. And then, when you look at the privacy settings, it's all disabled and Windows is just fast, smooth, and really responsive without you even having to do anything to get it to that point. So you might be wondering how that's even possible. Well, listen up and don't skip through this video because I'll show you exactly how you can do it too.
The hero we needed.
It doesn't matter. Once you update Windows, all the settings will be reverted. It's Windows' self-healing ability, which can even cause corruption in some cases.
But will it stay de-bloated?
What would happen if you install updates?
Can I install the Windows clipboard afterwards?
I need the old Internet Explorer on Windows 10. What should I change in the XML?
How can I make so the taskbar is on the center instead of on the left?
How to disable update till 2077?
It's been over a year since I released the first version of unattended WinStall or even updated the XML answer file. But today, that changes. I just released a new version of unattended WinStall that'll debloat and optimize Windows 10 or Windows 11 during the installation process so that you end up with a clean install just like this. A completely clean start menu, only the most needed and most useful Windows apps, and no Microsoft Edge, OneDrive, Copilot or Recall, by the way, disabled notifications, optimized privacy settings, and managed Windows updates, so that you have more control over your installation of Windows. Now, in case you don't know how this is even possible or how this works, let me give you a quick breakdown. Microsoft has an official deployment feature called Answer Files or Unattended Files, which you can add to Windows images or also called Windows ISO files. These answer files can be used to modify Windows settings on the Windows image, and they're executed during different phases of the Windows installation process. It's something that Microsoft developed to make mass deployments of Windows computers easier and faster, like in corporate environments for example, because you can automate many parts of the Windows installation process and decide how you want Windows to be configured once it's installed. What I like about using an answer file is that it's generally very safe because you can see every single change it's going to make to the Windows image by inspecting the answer file. There's also no need to download custom ISO files from unofficial sources because you insert it on the official Windows 10 or 11 ISO file that you download directly from Microsoft. And then lastly, it's also not dependent on any third-party tools because it's an official Microsoft feature. Now, I'm using this Microsoft feature to debloat, optimize, and customize Windows during the installation process so that by the time I load into Windows, everything is already set up for me and only the Windows apps I actually use are installed. Because let's be honest, Windows has a ton of bloatware these days. And then after this, the only thing left to do is to install the external software that I use and sign into the various websites that I use on a browser. The rest is pretty much set up already. And if I go and install all of the latest Windows updates and any of the bloatware gets reinstalled, like Microsoft Edge, OneDrive, or any of the other items for that matter, it'll just be uninstalled automatically the next time Windows starts up. This is done via the task scheduler in Windows, and if you want to prevent the automatic app uninstalls from taking place, you can just delete or disable the scheduled tasks associated with it. Now at this point, you're probably wondering how you can do a clean install of Windows with an answer or unattended XML file. The Windows setup automatically searches for answer files in specific locations on the Windows installation media. One of these locations is the root folder, meaning the main folder of the ISO that contains all of the Windows setup files. If you include a file called autounattend.xml with these files, the Windows setup will find it and execute the commands that are contained in it during different parts of the Windows installation process. There are a few different methods to include the XML file on the installation media, and I've already created in-depth guides on these, including video tutorials. And you can find all of that on the Unattended WinStall GitHub page that's linked in the description of this video, along with the video tutorials themselves. But I'm still gonna briefly mention some of them here, along with my recommended method. To start, you'll need to download the autounattend.xml file from the Unattended WinStall GitHub page. Now to do that, you can simply click on the file right here And then on the next page, you'll have this download button here. And then when you click on that, it's going to download the file. Now you can add this XML file to Windows installation media using one of the following methods. Method 1. You can create a Windows 10 or 11 bootable USB flash drive with Microsoft's media creation tool. And then you can just copy the auto-unattend.xml file to the root of the USB flash drive. Method 2. You can create a Windows 10 or 11 bootable USB flash drive with Rufus, and then copy the auto-unattend.xml file to the root of the USB flash drive. Just be sure not to select any of these checkboxes in Rufus, as it's going to create another answer file, potentially overriding the settings that you've defined in the auto-unattend.xml file that you copy to the USB flash drive. Method 3, you can use AnyBurn to edit a Windows 10 or 11 ISO file, add the auto-unattend.xml file to it, and then save a new version of the ISO file. This new ISO file can then be used to install Windows in a virtual machine, or you can create a bootable USB flash drive with Ventoy, copy the ISO file to it, and then install Windows using the Ventoy USB flash drive. This is what you would do if you wanted to install Windows on physical hardware. Method 4, and this is my recommended method. You can use Winhance, another utility that I developed, which contains the Windows Installation Media Utility, or WIMUtil for short. With WIMUtil, you can select a Windows 10 or Windows 11 ISO file and extract the contents of it to your computer. Once it's extracted, you can add an auto-unattend.xml file to it. At the time of this recording, you can add either an XML created by Winance, the latest unattended WinStall XML, which means you don't have to download it manually from GitHub, like I showed you earlier, or you can select another XML file that you might have created yourself, or with another XML generation service like Schneegans, for example. It's important to note, you can choose only one of these options. XML files from different services don't work together. In the next step, you'll be able to extract and add the drivers from the current operating system that you're using WIMUtil on to create this ISO file. And this is why I strongly recommend that you use this method, because Windows will automatically install all of the drivers during the setup process too, which can also save you a ton of time and frustration when reinstalling Windows. Now, step 2 and 3 are optional. If you only wanted to use WIMUtil to add drivers to your Windows installation media, and you don't want to use an auto-unattend XML file, then you can use WIMUtil just for that. But in the final step, you can choose a location to save the new ISO file, and then you can click on Start Creating to start creating that new ISO file. Once it's done, just like in Method 3, you can use the new ISO file to install Windows in a virtual machine, or you can use Ventoy to create a bootable USB flash drive so you can boot from it and then install Windows on physical hardware. The Windows installation process will be standard, and you'll still have to select your region and language, provide a valid Windows product key or select the option that you don't have one, and format and create a partition to install Windows on. During the Windows installation process, the auto-unattend.xml file will be read and the commands in it will be executed. After that, when you get to the Windows out-of-box or onboarding experience, you'll only be able to create a local account. You can't sign in with a Microsoft account here, but you will still be able to create an additional user account later on, and you can sign in with a Microsoft account on that user account if you really want that. When you load into Windows for the first time and you see the desktop, you'll be pleasantly surprised to see that it is clean, bloat-free, and feels responsive, the way Windows should be. If you created the ISO file with WIMUtil, and you chose to include the device drivers in the Windows installation media, they should also be installed already, but just in case they're not, you can manually install them by selecting Update Driver in Device Manager, choosing the Browse My Computer option, then navigating to the C drive, selecting the Windows folder, and then select the Drivers folder. Make sure the checkbox is selected to include subfolders, and then continue with the installation. The device driver should install successfully if all goes well. Now, since there's no browser installed, or any other software for that matter, you'll need a way to install it. Starting with version 3 of Unattended WinStall, I've made it so that there's a synergy between Winance and Unattended WinStall, and I've included a shortcut on the desktop to download and install Winance. So make sure you're connected to the internet, and then double-click on this install Winance file on the desktop and it's then going to download Winhance and prompt you to install it. Once Winhance has launched, you can navigate to the external software section, then choose the software that you want to install and click on the install button to start the installation. Now, I strongly advise that you use Winhance to install any Windows apps or to change any settings that you want to change in Windows after doing a clean Windows install with Unattended Winstall. The reason for this is Winhance will automatically update any of the removal scripts with your selections if you use it to reinstall Windows apps. For example, if you install Microsoft Edge with Winhance, it'll automatically delete the Edge removal script and scheduled task, so that Edge isn't automatically uninstalled the next time you start up your computer. In contrast, if you were to install Edge manually without Winhance, Edge would be removed automatically the next time you load into Windows, except if you manually delete or disable the scheduled task in Task Scheduler. Now, I just used Edge as an example, but this goes for any Windows app, legacy capability, or optional feature that you'll find in the Windows Apps and Features section of Winhance. You should install or enable it using Winhance to ensure that it'll stay installed. You also have control over these removal scripts and scheduled tasks if you click on the Help button in the Windows Apps and Features section. You can click on the relevant removal status icons, which will delete the script and task associated with it. But keep in mind, any bloatware that might be reinstalled with a Windows update will not be removed automatically anymore. Another reason I recommend using Winhance is you can see all of the settings that Unattended Winstall modified during the Windows installation, and you can change any of these settings according to your preference using Winhance. That is one of the reasons I created Winhance, to give users a way to revert the changes that were made by the Unattended Winstall answer file. Now you might be thinking, how can I edit this XML answer file? I mean, you might not like the fact that the calculator or paint is installed. Or maybe you actually want to keep Microsoft Edge. Or maybe you want to have light mode be the default instead of dark mode. Well, you can open the XML file in any code editor and then make the changes manually, if you know how, or ask an AI model to help you. But I would advise you to just create your own XML file with Winhance in that case. I just released a new version of Winhance recently, where you can now create your own auto-unattend.xml answer file based on your app and setting selections in Winhance. This way, you have full control over what apps are removed and what settings are applied. And since Unattended Winstall version 3 and onwards are created by Winhance and share a synergy with Winhance, you're not losing anything if you create your own file. In fact, you're gaining the ability to create the perfect version of Windows 10 or Windows 11 for you. If you're interested in that, you can watch the next video on screen now. It's a full in-depth demo of Winhance and will also explain how you can create your own XML answer file. I highly recommend checking it out. But with all of that being said, I hope you find this video and my work helpful. If you do, consider liking the video and donating to support the development of these projects. Every little bit helps, and you can find the links in the description. Thanks for all of your support, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.